I got myself recruited at Seed Cafe for today's Danu on Fire. We are super happy to have a brilliant actress who is world renowned for her work right here on Hi TV, your luxury channel. Incredible, Yashoda. I'm such a big fan of her and I'm so happy I'm having her on this show. And it's the first time I'm having her on one of my shows and I'm so happy for that. Thank you for joining me.
Yeah, happy to be here with you. I suppose you're on fire.
Fire or not, I'm definitely there. But thank you. Thank you. You look fabulous as always.
Thank you.
And someone who I recently spoke a lot about her with is Uncle Harris. We all call him that. He has dressed her for years. And
yes.
He always says...
Almost 30 years.
Yeah. And he always says, I trust... She trusts me enough to let me do what I have to do.
Yes, yes. Even today, it happened the same way. I have to go for this program. He chose everything. So I'm here.
That's amazing. So Yashoda, I saw you on screen when I was a little boy, doing commercials. And my mom used to always say, she's an absolute beauty. That's what she used to always say.
Okay.
How did you end up in this film fraternity and stay on for so long?
I started when I was a child, child in a sense. I was in my ninth grade when I first acted in a television series.
Okay.
It was a coincidence. Even in my dreams, I never thought of getting into films or into singing or whatever. I'm not into the entertainment.
Right.
Thing.
You're but a quiet little girl.
I was very quiet, very timid at school. Haven't even gone in front of the class to say some poem or something like that. And suddenly this opportunity came to me when they invited me for the television series. I said, I can't. I mean, I'm not interested.
Yeah.
Then actually my father, he's a well-known person, Ravilal Vemradar, maybe you know him. He said, no, he calls me Putta.
Mm.
Putta, you should try this and see. I have a feeling you will do it well.
Mm.
So because of his need, I went and did this.
Mm.
And actually it became quite interesting for me. The reason was, now, I'm Yashoda. This character is somebody else.
Yeah.
She was called Priyanka, a schoolgirl. How one could be somebody else in your heart and soul?
Yeah.
That's what the thought came into my mind.
And you were able to do anything as Priyanka?
Yes, yes.
Yeah.
So that was great. Great.
That's amazing.
Then I continued.
Continued. From the age of nearly 14.
Yeah.
13 or 14, must
yes.
be there. Please. So Yashoda is vegetarian. So keeping that in mind, we chose this beautiful place. It's called the Seed Cafe. They serve some awesome food. If you're someone who likes to be healthy, if you're someone who likes to be gluten-free, vegan, whatever, the options are limitless. We've got our little starters here and it's amazing. Even the drinks are, this is completely vegan and that's vegetarian. It's amazing, yes. Right? Yeah. So why are you vegetarian? And when did you become vegetarian? You can.
As a child, I'll stick to this first.
Ah, okay.
As a child, I didn't like the taste of fish or meat or anything like that.
So from a
I didn't
young
like
age.
The smell of the fish from very young age. But then my mother used to forcefully feed me fish. You have to have fish because otherwise no calcium in you and all that. So I used to, you know, drop it. But when I started schooling and then around the, when I realized things, when I grew up as a teen, I completely stopped all the meat and fish and everything.
And
went directly into vegetarian. I'm not a vegan. I take dairy food. Yes.
Yeah, and that's good because you would eat it. Otherwise, it's very hard and it's very expensive in our country to be vegan.
Yes, I know. I know.
But at the same time, being vegan in a Sri Lankan recipe is very easy. Like all the nallung and all the Now, you have this love for Hindi.
Yes.
And you have a master's in Hindi.
Yes.
Am I correct?
Yes.
Why? First, I need to ask why.
Why? Yeah. Because as a child, I could speak in Hindi like in English or Sinhala. Because my father was a Hindi lecturer at Kalani University and he studied in Lucknow University, India. So even my mother and my sister, we all can speak Hindi.
Wow, like are you, I'm sure your house, they must be like, kuch kuch kahiye.
Then later on, when it comes to my O-levels, I thought I should take it as a subject.
Oh, okay.
So then I did it for A-levels. Then I
never knew they had a subject called Hindi for A-levels.
Yes, you have. You have all the new, even Chinese, Korean, everything is there. If you want to study, maybe you won't have teachers in the school,
but
still you can take it.
Brilliant.
So
all right.
I went to Kalani University, did a Hindi honors degree, then I went to Lucknow to do my master's.
That's amazing. I'll speak more about a fun thing that I remember when she interviewed Shah Rukh Khan when he came to Sri Lanka.
Yeah, that's how I got the opportunity.
Yes, because I still remember we were all just like, hold on, we don't still understand anything because they both spoke in Hindi and you're like, okay.
But they had subtitles.
I remember this because it was a live stream from the airport.
Yeah.
We'll speak more when we do come back. It's Done on Fire right here on Hi TV, your luxury channel. And we are speaking to the beautiful Yashoda about life, food and everything. Can you cook?
Yes, I can.
Are you a good cook?
I hardly find time to cook, but I always cook for my mother these days actually. She's not very well. Yeah.
So are you?
I don't know how good it is, but Amma eats it somehow. Not like your sister. I'm not a good cook like her.
She has maintained this physique. That's a problem. I blame her. But your understanding about life, I'm sure in this industry it's very hard for you to make friends, real friends.
Yeah.
How did you challenge and work through that?
I grew up in the industry actually from the age of 14 And I'm happy for that because I learned so much the reality of this society. It's very fake, to tell you the truth. And there are many, many fake people, you know, you talk to the face very nicely and behind your back they say something else. So I realized that from a very small age. So it gave me so much strength, courage to how to handle myself, how to go in this path. If I want to succeed in life, I have to take it in a you know balanced way.
Yeah.
Otherwise, if I get hurt by what people say, if I react to what all of them say, I mean without my reaction, if they don't get a reaction,
then
they definitely stop.
So
I didn't. I never reacted to those. Those are my father's advice.
Mm.
So he guided me so well.
Because he knew the industry.
Yes,
he knew it. Yeah.
He knew it.
Because back in the days, you have to have some and try.
Okay.
This one doesn't eat much. I have to force her to put on some weight here.
No, I like avocado.
Ah, super. There you go. As a vegetarian, you don't have much options. No. See, me, I have a lot. Now, I wanted to ask you, social media came about in the last few years and completely dominated this industry.
Mm.
How have you handled this social media invasion and how do you see it?
I started way ahead, way before this social media or anything like that. But I think I became the most popular actress for continuously 5 years. No social media,
nothing.
No SMS, no internet, nothing. Just a piece of coupon published in a paper, and people actually had a process to write on it, cut it.
Post it.
Yeah. Go to a post box, post it. So they had a procedure.
And that means
that is genuine.
Yeah, and that feels
If you don't feel it, you don't do all the trouble and go and post it. So I'm happy that I was most popular at that time.
Mm.
But when social media came, there are good sides and bad sides to it. People should know how to use it, why we are using it. There are a lot of reasons you can use it. As a professional, I use my social media, either profile or page or Instagram or whatever. I use it thoroughly for my professional activities.
Only?
Yes.
Yeah.
So if you know how to handle it, it's great. You can go to the world.
Yeah,
totally. Yes.
But if you abuse it, of course,
yes.
The news comes out.
Most of the people are abusing it in Sri Lanka. And that is the sad part of it. With awareness only, people get to know how to use this. It's a brilliant advertising media, which I have used all my, you know, I started in 2009 or 10. So
I see her on Instagram, she'll put a picture, you reshare. I get a rose when I tag her on a story. So you're the first one who has ever sent me a rose,
yes.
A digital rose. Everyone sends me a heart.
Oh.
So it's different and I like it. Now today the industry has become so crowded. We have so many people. Today everyone is an actor or a model or an actress or a because you know I just need to take a picture and I'm like, whoa, I'm a model.
Photoshop.
Yeah, Photoshop. But now you don't even need to Photoshop. You can just do everything on the phone.
Yeah.
How has that changed? No, everyone is in the industry. Industry is so cluttered. But is there quality coming out? There's quantity though.
Very sad story. Unfortunately, quality is lost. Quantity is there, but you don't even know the new generation who are actors, real actors. You don't see them much on television. There are a certain set of people who come only in social media.
Yeah.
And they say they are models, they are actors, they are singers and all of that.
Mm-hmm.
But to be a real actor, you have to go through the process, you have to learn acting. I am a person who always say, I came up to this level by learning. I'm still learning and I use the techniques of acting. You have to professionally learn it. Otherwise, you may have your born talent, but to succeed with it, you have
techniques.
To, you know, yeah. You have to learn and practice. It's like being a singer. If he doesn't practice his, train his voice, he will lose it.
Yeah, true.
It's the same as artist. Mm. You have a training, so.
Okay, and when we do come back after the break, we are going to be speaking a little bit about this brilliant offer that she got in India, and she has movies in India as well. We would have lost her to India, but we'll speak more. What stopped her from this? When we do come back, right here on Dhanush. One thing for sure, taking her out on a date is very affordable. She doesn't eat much and that gives me more food. If I was Joey from Friends, I'll be a very happy person. But you don't eat sweets.
No, I'm not a sweet fan.
Really?
Yes.
I want those skills in my life, man. Not to like
you
sweets.
Better.
Yeah.
You know, better have that.
When people tell me, oh, I don't like sweets, so I'm like, how? I think it's a genetic problem for me. But what she was telling me is, how can I be in this industry for 35 years and still be the girl and not the mum's role? Because can't. Because you look the same. It's a huge
yes.
problem. No? It's a problem. Can't. Because of you.
It's a problem for the others, not for me.
Now, I wanted to speak to you about, so I was actually just I never knew that she acted in a like a Indian film, and I was going through YouTube for something and I saw Yashoda. Yashoda? It was just to see it's her, but it was a Malayalam film, right?
Yes, that was in 1991.
How did that happen?
That happened, my very first movie was called Guru Gedara, and normally we used to process our films in
India,
in Chennai, in Prasad Lab. So one of the Malayalam directors have seen my the footage of my work, and he had asked her, can we cast her in one of our films? So that's how I got it. So they contacted me and I went and played that role. It was called Acharyan, directed by a director called Ashokan, and it was a great experience.
And how did the public react to you?
Public, actually, we had shooting in different schedules because I had work here also, and the other actors also had work, like people like Vineet, Suresh Gopi, Tilagan, they are superstars there.
Yeah.
Vineet was new at that time, so when the second schedule started, we were shooting outside, and people used to come and talk to me in Malayalam.
Because
we looked the same, and even the atmosphere is the same, food is the same as Sri Lanka. If you go to Mataram, those kind of food, we get it there.
Oh,
so
wow.
We are very similar.
Because Kerala food and Jaffna food are very similar.
Yes, yes.
Yeah.
It's
so
like
that's amazing.
That.
So, and you didn't take up all the other film offers that came soon after that?
Yes, I was offered, while I was doing it, I was offered 3 Malayalam movies.
Gosh.
I remember Vineet was pleading me, just do one. By that time, I was able to speak a little bit of Malayalam as
okay.
well.
Because if you have learnt Hindi so much,
yes.
because you could have easily transitioned into Hindi as well, no?
Yes. So he said, at least do one more and go. Then I actually wanted to stay back because I like the way they work. It's
and
different.
Advanced in, yeah.
Yeah. Different to the way we are working here, not technology-wise. But the way they respect artists
and discipline
and that I didn't see it here. Sorry to say, but that's the reality. Then I called and asked my father, can I stay back and do this? Then by that time I have taken up work here also.
Okay. And your first film was already done there in Malayalam.
Yeah, that was done while shooting only I got it.
Oh.
While I was doing Acharya. So I got these offers. So I wanted to at least do one more.
Yeah, true.
Then I called and asked him, can I stay back and do this? Then he said, by that time I have taken up work in Sri Lanka as well. I was a newcomer at that time. But so I was getting more and more roles here. But then I started to reschedule my work. They didn't help me in Sri Lanka because I was a newcomer. Mm. And
they like, you don't set standards.
They won't
now.
Give priority to me. Then one day my father said, I know you like to stay there and do it and there's no problem in it. But remember, if you establish in India, you're just a second class citizen there. But if you really establish in Sri Lanka, people will love you because it's your country, you belong here. So I had to say bye and come. I took my father's
advice.
Words. But today I feel I definitely should have stayed back.
And
because
done.
the opportunity is more from south, they go to, because
north,
of my language ability. Speaking
and
Hindi.
And also the fact that it's just for you.
I could have gone to Bollywood, I could have gone to other parts, Kolkata. Kolkata is the place that you get advanced movies. So I'm more into that type. So that's life.
But in a way, selfishly I have to say I'm happy that came back. You. Otherwise, I would have never had you on Danuan Farm. I have to wait.
And apart from that, I did a lot of international movies which were shot here.
Like Mother Teresa you acted
in. Yes, and Iqbal and Return to Bangalore, so much more. I got that. I played all Indian women's roles because of my language ability. They always took me for those films.
It's amazing. Alright, well, Ashoda, as always, it has been absolutely a pleasure. It's just like how I will talk to her somewhere when we meet. Thank you so very much for coming. Thank you for being here and being so simple and humble and no drama at all. And that's so beautiful because I think that's why you are so loved. For the fact that you're so approachable and so friendly and just you blend in with everyone and that's wonderful. Thank you so very
much.
Thank you.
Thank you very much, Danu, for having me in your show. But I hope you didn't have much fun.
No, I did. But the best part is I get more food. I have to eat this as well. On that note, we need to wrap things up on the show. Thank you so very much for joining us today on Danu on Fire. Until we see you soon, keep smiling.